unlike the other two colleges, that is Somaiya and Father Abner, HMDI is an autonomous college now.
Yes, sir.
And I believe so is Ramlawadi, isn't it?
Yes, sir. It is affiliated to Mumbai University.
Things are same like what?
Oh, Mumbai University only?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But I thought you were a university or something.
Only IIT is like, all everybody is included.
Yes, other 60 courses are under Devakarani University. Accepting,
you know, this RIIT. Oh, RIIT is Bombay University.
Still affiliated with Mumbai.
Oh, I thought I was getting at least one different sample. Only VJTI is my solas.
And sir, PNIT is also there.
Oh, okay. We
have to
go. No, but Bombay
College.
North Maharashtra University. North okay, so
yes, sir.
He was telling us that although it is autonomous, basically they are still following roughly the same pattern, but they have seen
first semester is C programming, C++ plus plus is in the second semester.
But that means the fundamental programming concepts, at least procedural programming.
Procedural, yes. The first semester emphasis is on the procedural programming.
So, the first semester will be very similar,
to C. Discuss. Yes, yes.
We will discuss RIS.
Yeah, complete C programming, everything, syllabus.
And in the second semester, do you actually start with object-oriented programming?
There is
some kind of a revision of similar
revision, then emphasis. Of, yes, first
and
revision.
Teaching pattern and evaluation
pattern is similar? No, teaching this evaluation pattern has changed. Teaching pattern is generally left to the teacher.
Okay.
Generally, every teacher is expected to give the lesson plan, and accordingly, that is handed over to the student in advance. Similarly, the lab assignments also are given in advance. That
so
is the thing.
Lecture hours and lab hours
according to my knowledge, they were same as 2 hours per week for the CP1, that is computer programming one.
2 hours
per week and 2 hours per week for the practical.
For the
labs.
2 hours for the lab.
Right, sir.
And there also the lab work will have similar, some 15, 20 programs.
That yeah, around minimum 10 we are expecting it.
Minimum 10.
10 is it. One, but one can go beyond that also. One can.
And the evaluation pattern?
Evaluation pattern has changed. Earlier, now there is an emphasis on the mid-sem. We have got three tests. Test 1, mid-sem test and second test. And there is a weightage given for the term work marks. So that is 20 marks for the mid-sem test and 10 marks for test 1 and test 2. And yeah, and then that is again converted into 15 marks.
How is that? Two tests together is 15 marks.
Right? Two tests together is 15 marks.
Even plus T2 is 15%.
Yeah. So total weightage comes to less. So the mid sem is 20 marks. That is again converted to 10 marks. So the whole weightage is the 30 marks for the assessment. That is including the term work they do it.
Term work is 5 marks.
No, no. 30 marks is the total weightage for the test term plus work. Term work.
Okay.
The term work will consist of the assignments followed by the oral.
I see.
Oral. And test will consist of that 15 marks. Now, while actually conducting the test, the mid-sem will be conducted for the 20 marks. That will be converted into 10 marks. The test 1, test 2 will be given for the 10 marks. That is converted to 5 marks. And that way it will be evaluated. Yeah.
Tests.
Yes.
And how much for the term of assignment required?
15 marks.
So total
30
marks.
30 marks. Yeah. But final exam would be for 100 marks. That will be, those marks will be converted into to 70 marks. And that 70 plus 30
so
and then ultimately converted into grades.
30-70
is the weightage.
In semester evaluation and
and semester evaluation. But the total weightage given for the continuous evaluation works out to be little lesser. That is what is my personal thing.
So the 70 marks paper.
No. No, paper would be of 100 marks.
Paper
yeah.
Paper, 100
right.
Marks paper.
100 marks.
The paper is sent by the teacher who teaches.
There is a one coordinator who is coordinating for all the divisions. We have got around 440 intake for the first year.
440.
Yeah, that consists of electrical, mechanical, civil, and then they are divided into divisions. So, first year consists of all the, it is not as per the admitted branch, but they are converted. And then, for particularly for first year, for the last 3 years, what our institute has done is, they have converted the classroom for the 120, and for first year classes is being held there. And every
four groups or four divisions
we can say.
And there is one teacher.
One teacher is appointed as a coordinator, and maybe there will be two teachers will be associated who will be actually teaching the subject. They will decide it what should be the course of action and the planning of this, and then all this mid-sem test is common for all, so that is decided by both the coordinator along with the other teaching faculty members. Then during the practical, as far as the environment is concerned, right now we have got only the Windows environment. The client machines are Windows XP, there is a Windows 2003 server, but then the practicals are being done on the Turbo C only. So the syllabus, even though I said that it is an old syllabus, still we are not using the Unix in practice.
But is it possible for your teachers and your group to get acquainted with a, let's say, a double boot environment? Because ultimately you are teaching programming.
Yeah.
You're not really teaching operating system.
Right.
So if you have seen in our lab environment also, I mean, you just need a command line prompt.
Right, sir.
And you need that environment. So do you think it will be difficult to introduce that? Because teaching C programming is more important than the operating system on which you teach that.
My experience is, sir, in particularly in our institutions, we do have a lot of mental blocks to change over to this.
But
C or C plus means only Turbo C. I tried that in the past also, but I would say that I failed in that environment. I will definitely do that with the support of our director. I will try to change the course. That is from my side, I can do
it. Change the course.
Like course in the sense, the mindset or the environment on this.
Environment,
yeah.
Actually, one advantage you would have is you would say that, look, if we use this environment, then the entire material created collaborative by 1,000 people
would be
available to us.
Right, sir.
If we don't do it, it will not be available.
Right.
That should be the winning argument.
Yeah.
The advantage of going on.
So presently what we have for the first year is there is a separate lab, what we call it as a common computing facility. And that is being handled by a different professor, and that is particularly only for the first year. So all the four.
We could talk to that particular professor in that particular first year lab and try to see whether that lab environment, how many machines are there?
There are around 50 machines are there.
50.
And generally 60 students are coming for the practical.
How 50 machines and 60 students?
50 machines are working. Actually, capacity is more there. But that sometimes the machines are down. So this is all my observation. This is not an authentic information from any of the source. Yeah.
But for the labs, again the same teachers have to handle the lab.
Generally, the one who is teaching theory will be associated with the practical and assisted by the TAs, M.Tech students.
Oh, we
do have TAs.
That reminds me, I am going to conduct a one-week orientation program for TAs. Because I am going to teach CS 101 myself. So, my contention is whatever we do here, I should be able to use it for my own course in IIT as well. But then I will really put my heart into it. That was the idea of accepting that. So this teaching of, I mean, training for TAs is also going to be recorded. So in case people would like to use TAs, you know, this 1 week training program for TAs will also make it public. And that can also be used wherever you want.
Definitely, sir.
So that's how it is.
Yes, sir.
So essentially, you have started making progress on autonomy slowly.
Yeah.
The biggest gain is, of course, the paper is sent by the people who teach that course.
Teach that, yes, sir.
That is the biggest advantage of the autonomy in class. So I know exactly what I have taught, therefore I can
ask it.
But the question paper pattern, do you still have the probabilistic kind of pattern where some theory portion and some problem?
I don't think there are drastic changes in that, and I am not at this point.
So
I
that
won't be.
Know when we get
yeah,
to see the
yes, sir.
Of course, these things take time.
Yeah, this. One thing I would like to add: our regular examination, once it gets over, because of autonomy, that within the 1 month, there is a re-examination. So those who are not able to clear the examination, yeah, re-exam system is there. So within a 1 month, the re-exam would be conducted, and again the result would be declared within 15 days, and the student has got an option or opportunity to clear in case if they could not clear in the first attempt.
The student fails in the lab portion, or there is a composite passing?
There is a composite. Lab portion doesn't is separate. There is no passing head for that. Or probably the teacher sees to it that he does the lab work properly, then only his term work is granted. Otherwise not.
You know that term
work. Yeah, term work, so like so that yeah, that is consist of the attendance as well as what work actually is being done.
5 marks attendance.
5 marks, yeah, that also is there. Some weightage for the attendance is also there.
My only worry with the attendance is that when you have a class of 60, as it is, the teacher's time is so precious that even wasting 5 minutes in taking attendance is
yes,
doing harm to the students. More
yeah,
useful things in life than deck marking. But anyway, it's part of it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, sir.